Steady, steady. It's very, very nice to see you. I probably don't think you feel the same way about me, though, do you?
That's right. No.
I bet you're looking forward to seeing it.
Oh, I am. I was such a wally.
No, you weren't. No, you weren't. You... Well, maybe you were, but no, you weren't. It's an interesting one because we asked Judy to do something that no doubt she's done many times before, which is work on a corporate video for a company that was decidedly dodgy. They were called Pocklington Plastics. And they have a trading policy that means they've got factories all over the remote areas of Wales and Scotland. Hence, the factories were at towns and villages with unpronounceable names. The script, you didn't get a chance to see, did you?
I didn't get a script.
Good. And so we put it all on auto cue, but, and you'll see the words come up on the screen now, but the auto cue kept breaking down. And of course, then you've got to re-record the thing all over again. So you're only seeing a shortened version of something that was pure murder for Judy. So how does she manage with the whole thing? She even had a chairman who had the most peculiar personal problem. And she dealt with that in an interesting way.
Stand by quiet, please.
Hello, I'm Judy Spires, and welcome to this video presentation, which I'll be looking at one of the most dynamic and unusual companies in British industry, Pocklington Plastics. In the last 12 months, the Pocklington vision of small, highly flexible manufacturing units has been brought to 11 new locations in rural Scotland and Wales, from Ash na Shelach in the Highlands to Clandrignog in Powys, from Inch na Danff and Drum na Drochi on opposite banks of Loch Ness to Clandrig on the shores of Cardigan Bay. But of course, the highlight of the year was the opening of Pocklington's 20th manufacturing centre at... I didn't try that one. Chlwyngol.
Yes? I just had a word from the PR man who says that the shouldn't be overstressed.
Mm-hmm. Lily. I'll be looking at one of the most dynamic and unusual companies in British industry. Sorry, autocue's gone. I'll be looking at one of the most dynamic and unusual companies in British industry. It's gone again.
No, it's nothing. Autocue's gone again, Peter. Autocue's gone again.
Though, no doubt, even the Prince was pleased to hear that there are no plans for Pocklington to move into Llanfair, Hwchgwingich, Gogerich, Llanrobil, Llantasilio, Gogogo. Now, let's take a look at some of the products which have contributed to... It's gone.
That was excellent.
There are no plans for Pocklington to move into Llanfair, Hwchgwingich, Gogerich, Llandrobil, Llantasilio, Gogogoch. But now, let's take a look at some of the products which have contributed to Pocklington Plastics' conspicuous success in the past year.
I like the laugh at the end of the long one.
It was relief. Fear was the key, I think, there, really.
Now, the demonstration.
Oh, goody. Do I demonstrate, do I?
Oh, yes.
Oh, do I? Oh, gosh.
Yes,
it's years like... since I've done this in Debenhams with a vegetable cutter. In the past year, this toilet brush, produced in a range of colours at two factories in Wales, has won favour with the largest contractor in this field. Meanwhile, two of the major chains of fast food outlets have equipped themselves with these elegant but easy to clean palm fronds. And they...
Toilet brush. Lovely.
Lovely. Super yeah. Darling on the toilet brush.
Palm fronds, we... I think
the but the thing is, the thing is, I don't want to make fun with the product, but I want to have fun with the item.
Yeah.
And it's a very delicate sort
of... Well, I would have lots of fun with the palm fronds.
Would you?
Yes.
quite honestly.
Okay. But whatever, I think it will be...
His pencil case containing a handy sharpener and the essential ruler reminds Chelsea supporters that blue really is the colour.
The Chelsea doodad is a bit dull.
Excuse me, I'm a classical actress. I'm not used to palm fronds.
Could I do something with them? Up the Chelsea, what's
well,
on
there? Blue is the colour.
Blue is the colour. What, do you want me to just go?
Why not?
But perhaps the most spectacular success has been with this ingenious household item. A compact indoor washing line. Almost 100,000 units have been supplied to shops. This success is characteristic of the Pocklington approach. So now, let's hear from the man who embodies it, the founder and chairman of Pocklington Plastic, Robert Pocklington.
Right. Yeah.
It's going awfully well, isn't it? Ignore everybody. I mean, camera-wise, and just...
Yes. Well,
I'll just read the questions out and ask them to. Can't help you with the answers.
It's so weird being sitting next to you here.
A lot of people have said that. Oh, do you? That's nice.
Oh, well, we can.
That one again. Stand by quiet, please.
Robert, your company has 20 sites spread right across Britain. Does that make sense?
Yes, that's right. We have 20 sites. And it's a very interesting question.
Robert, your company has 20 sites, and they're spread right across Britain. Does that actually make sense?
Yes, it makes a great deal of sense, because we believe in working in a small way with...
Do you want to take Robert and...
It's embarrassing. We are expanding. We've got more... another place that's going to open in...
Well, I hope you...
Near Mould.
Your pronunciation's probably better than mine. I thought it was going awfully well. Robert, did you not encounter problems at all in recruiting and training your workforce?
First of all...
The fire precautions clearly state that this must be a fire retardant material. And it's not, is it?
It's not.
However, this is not.
Oh, God!
This is not inflammable. It is from television's foremost academy. Judy Spires. Would you prefer a gotcha, Oscar, or do you want to get the toilet brush and hold her?
I want that little camping line.
What it is... I mean, I always feel the need to be polite to people having put them through the ordeal, but you were incredibly kind to the man when the wig went. What went through your mind?
I've done worse on network television, to be honest. And I thought, think of the money, because I'd booked a holiday on the strength of that, and I ended up at 4-9 Budney Salterton.
You enjoyed it?
I did. It was. I had a wonderful time. But, I mean, he might have been ill, poor man.
Yes.
I don't know.
Yes. Anyway, I've got an extra for you.
Oh.
Here it is. A gold-encrusted hang line. And that's